So this change is so great that it deserves the set of its own. Where we look here, that's the attempt to move the arms upwards and respectively the total bodily behavior that comes in package with it. So you can see that everything goes in a standard way. We can observe the drag of the pectorals, well, the fusion of the pectorals, so lack of the arms freedom of the front. And of course, that also means that the shoulder girdle is elevated if we follow the principle of latitudes and longitudes. So that would be a longitudinal elevation. And then we also see how respectively the head gets into this forwards dive. And then, of course, we observe the entire move and the drag of the torso with respective double action of the legs and the dependence of the feet, where we can also see that the toes are very curled and pulled up. And this beginning of the movement itself, right? It's exactly the same phases. And you can see this transition is really a remarkable change. And then, yes, of course, at the end, the pectorals, they do cause a certain drag of the muscle mass of the chest wall, but you can really see the big transition and the freedom of the shoulder girdle from the position of the head in that longitudinal fashion. So that's what we were discussing, that longitudinally, now there is a separation. So the shoulder girdle works in the with sits within its own latitude. Plus, we see that divisions between the torso and the arm, and that gives this set of freedoms at the top, but also, no less important, is the set of freedoms at the bottom, because here you can see the individual moves of the legs, how they adjust, and also you can see, of course, the sitting platform. And then what I particularly get impressed with here is the switch of the lower leg and the activation of the toes, so which are meaningfully touching the ground and providing the additional type of the positional and sensory feedback.